Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 8.1, Problem 4. This is Section 8.1, Problem number 4. It says, National Grid serves over 20,000 customers in Bristol County. The 20,000 customers have a population mean monthly electric bill of $142 and a population standard deviation of $38. Find the probability that a random sample of 100 National Grid customers has an average monthly bill of A, more than $150. So the $150 bill, this is something that we have to look up in that standard normal chart. So we'll have to find the z-score for the 150 and look it up. So the formula to find the z-score is z equals x minus the mean over the standard deviation. Now for this problem, x, the number I want the z-score for, is 150. Minus the mean. Now, I can use the population mean of 142, but in reality, what I want is the mean of the samples of size 100, which would come out to 142 also, over the standard deviation. Now, here there's going to be a little bit of a difference. I want the standard deviation, how spread out the samples of 100 are from one sample of 100 to the next, not one customer to the next. From one customer to the next, the average amount of spread in the electric bill is $38 a month. But that's not what I want for this. I want the average amount of spread or the standard deviation from one sample of 100 customers to the next sample of 100 customers. So that's what they call the standard error of the mean. It's the standard deviation of the population divided by the square root of the sample size. So for this particular problem, the sample size is 100. That's why the 100 in the denominator, in the square root, don't forget the square root, and then the top is the 38, the standard deviation for the population. That's a measure of how spread out one sample of 100 is to the next sample of 100. So let's clean this up a little bit. We'll have z equals, I can actually do the top, but I'll leave it for one more step, 150 minus 142, 38 over 10. Square root of 100 is 10, because 10 times 10 is 100. So that'll give me z equals, so on top, 150 minus 142 is 8. In the denominator, I can write that as 3.8. 38 divided by 10 is 3.8. That's easy enough. Now the next step, if it was 8 over 4, I know it would be 2, so it's going to be close to 2, but I can't really do that type of division in my head very easily, so I'll just use the calculator. The numerator divided by the denominator equals 2.10523158. That's the z-score. That's what I need to look up. So the process to look up a z-score is, first, write the number to look up so that it has two places after the decimal. This has a lot more than two. So I go to two places after the decimal. I'm at the zero. The next place out is a 5. That is just barely big enough to make it a 2.11. So what we will look up is 2.11. Now, the next step is split the number to look up into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So it'll be 2.1, and the rightmost one I pull off to one side. The next step is put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. So instead of a 1, it's a 0.01. And now we can go to the chart, the positive 2.1 row. Again, you must pay attention to positive or negative, and intersect it with a 0.01 column. And they would intersect at 0.9826. That's the value from the chart. Now, that may or may not be the answer to the question I have. If the question is a less than question, the number from the chart, in this case 9826, would be the answer. If it's a greater than question, I have to do 1 minus the number from the chart. So as I look back at the original question, part A, it says more than $150. That's greater than. So I have to do 1 minus the chart value, 1 minus 0.9826, that would be 0.0174. So the answer to part A is 0.0174. It's about a 1 3/4% probability that a group of 100 customers, the average of that random sample of 100, that the average would come out to be more than 150. So B, what's the probability that that random sample of 100 customers has an average that's less than 140? So it's going to be the same process. I'm going to use the z-score formula, fill it in. So initially, the beginning fills in very similar. Let me keep my z-score formula on the board and erase some of the work underneath it. So now for my z-score, the x, the number I want to find the z-score for, is now 140. The mean is still 142. And again, it's coincidentally the same as the mean of the population, but in reality what I want is the mean of the samples of size 100, which would be the same. And now the standard deviation, again, when I'm doing this, it's not the standard deviation of the population, it's the standard deviation of the population divided by the square root of the sample size. What I'm looking for is the measure of how spread out the samples of 100 are from one to the next. So, now on top, 140 minus 142 is negative 2. Don't lose the negative, make a huge difference. And that'll be 38 over 10, which is 3.8, like the previous part of the problem. So what I need to do with my calculator is negative 2 divided by 3.8. Again, not something I would do easily in my head, but the calculator will do immediately for me. So let's do negative 2 divided by 3.8 equals, and I get negative 0.52631578. That's the z-score. That's what I need to look up. So to look up any number in the chart, I have to first write it so that it has two places after the decimal. So I can write that as negative 0.53. As I go to two places after the decimal, I'm at the 2. The next position after that is big enough to make it a negative 0.53. So, once you have the number written so that it has two places after the decimal, the next thing you want to do is split that number into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. The 3 comes off. And then after that, you put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that you pulled off. So instead of 3, it's 0.03. Now you go to the chart, make sure you're in the negative portion of the chart. You look in the negative 0.5 row, intersect that with a 0.3 column, and it would intersect at point, let's see, 2981 is where they intersect. So, now again, that's the number from the chart. It may or may not be my final answer. Part B does say less than. So any question that's a less than, the number from the chart is your final answer. So the number from the chart was 0.2981. Then the final answer is 0.2981 for less than. If it had said greater than or more than, like part A, I'd have to do 1 minus the chart value. Now, B, between 140 and 150, what's the probability that a group of 100 randomly chosen customers, the average of that group of 100 would come out somewhere between 140 and 150? Well, this is an in-between question. So you're going to have two chart values and you're going to subtract them. Now fortunately, we found the chart number for both of these. So the 140 we just did is 0.2981. Now the 150, careful, the final answer for our 150 is not the chart number because it was a greater than. The chart number, I guess I erased it, was 0.9826. So we got the answer for A by doing 1 minus the chart value. So those are my two chart values. Now to find the in-between probability, I have to subtract those two. Subtract in an order that will give me a positive result, because the result is a probability. you can't have a negative probability. So off to the side, I'll make a little bit of room to do that computation. I'll have 0.9826 minus 0.2981. One chart value minus the other chart value. And again, the answer from the chart value, not the final answer for the question. So 6 minus 1 is 5. The next column I have to borrow, so it's going to be 12 minus 8 is 4. I have to borrow again. That'd be 8 and then 6. 0.6845. So the probability that a group of 100 customers randomly chosen would have an average that falls somewhere between 140 and 150, it's about a 68.5% probability, roughly. And then D, is the size of the sample important in determining if the distribution of sample means is normal? Now, that can be an important question. So what you have to ask yourself is, do we know that the original population is normally distributed? The customers for National Grid, their electric bills, doesn't really say, and you can't be sure. So that means it is important, the sample size is important. If you're not sure, the sample size must be at least 30, which we have. It's a 100, the sample size, so it's plenty more than 30. If we knew for sure that the electric bills, the monthly bills for the National Grid customers were normally distributed, and they may or may not be, we could have sample sizes of below 30, and our Z-score process would work great. But since we don't know one way or the other, we have to do a sample size of 30 or more. So the question to D, is the size of the sample important? Yes, it is. In this case, it is because we don't know if the population is normal or not.